having your cake and eating it too.
All right, another morning of doing your job here on First News, and you're about to see me up to my arms in Crisco, sugar, and a sweet-tasting bakery run by a woman taking a huge gamble.
So far, we have our chocolate chip scones, we have the Russian tea cakes, we have the cinnamon rolls, we have our lemon blueberry pound cake.
It's mid-morning inside Lawrence's Pink Box Bakery, and Michelle Kaminsky isn't even halfway through her day.
And yeah, it was probably crazy, but I just said, it's, you know, sometimes you just got to do it, and I did.
What she did was give up a successful career in test marketing to open up her own bakery, and she did it last fall in the middle of a recession. The odds were she wouldn't last long, but here she is.
And I really do think that, you know, it comes down to price, to concept, and product.
The Pink Box concept has caught on. So has the product. Like any small business, she's starting small.
You'll laugh when you go back to my kitchen. I don't have a piece of professional equipment back there. We are getting a professional oven in 2 weeks just because of volume.
So we want to go all the way around? So here I am in the middle of making an expensive armadillo cake.
It's a good foundation.
I haven't ruined it.
No, not yet.
Well, whatever.
That's cake artist Leanna Myers. It's a lot of cake, a lot of icing, and a lot of something called fondant, which if you don't know, is melted marshmallows and powdered sugar. When it hardens, it'll form the shell of the cake.
I've never done this before.
But to work the fondant, you have to grease up first with Crisco up to your elbows. Sure, it's a mess, but take a look at the final product. It's well worth it.